Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this epic tutorial series on DocUI. Now, what is DocUI? SwiftUI for UIKit. You heard that right, SwiftUI for UIKit. Well, kind of. And today we are going to talk about alert controllers. So let's jump right into the code. Okay, in the previous episodes, we have been talking about logging and debugging. Well, logging in the console, so you know how to debug your code and debug on your UI views on the screen. So let me just show you how that looks like on the screen. So you can debug visually what you have put out that there in your UI. So today we are going to move even further. So now you do have all of those information, but most probably you will need to alert your users too. So that's why the alert controller comes in. So basically that is a simple UI alert controller. And let me just show you by example, it will be super fast and easy. So let me just see what we got here. Let's add a button right down here. Why not? And we just leave the debugging there. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go ahead and take a look at the previous episode in this playlist. You can have take a look at the description for the details of the links for the playlist, you know. So let's move forward. Let's create a button real quick. So let button, it will be a UI button. Okay, and yeah, that is going to be just a UI button. Let's add a text to it, and the text will be tap me. And let's see, let's have a background color, maybe. Background color, yeah. Let's use our decolors. Decolor, let's see, dark, Xcode 11, first of all, and dark. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, take a look at the previous episodes. I go into detail what the color is and so on. So let's add a corner radius to, let's say 5. And as you can see, this is how easy it is to construct a button. So yeah, there we go. Let's add that corner radius. Yeah, and this should be fine. Okay, there we have our button. So let's add it under our label that is inside the horizontal stack. So I would just add it here. So a button. Okay, let's maybe add some insets too. So insetting, and I will set the insetting to 12. Now, let's see how that looks. Let's hit Command R or that play button and see how all of that looks like. Tap me. There we go. Really, really useful and fun to create UI as simple as that with DocUI. Now, if you recall, or if you just go ahead and take a look at my other video on buttons, we need to create an observable, an observe on our button. And that is pretty simple. So a button dot reactive dot tap and observe next. There we go, observe next. And we are just going to delete this for now because we want to add a weak self there, but we are not going to do that. Finally, we want to dispose this in the bag. I won't go into details why this is. I am explaining all of this in the episode of buttons. Well, basically what we want to do here is show an alert. So for now, let's use our trusty log and let's have a success log here. Again, this is, if this is brand new to you, go ahead and take a look at the other videos. They are titled real nice, like log and button, so you can find everything that you are searching for. So tapped button. Okay, and yeah, that should be it. We have added 3, 4 5 lines of code, well, basically 7 lines of code, but this could be numbered as only one. But just for readability, we have these 2 extra lines, and we do have that button. So let's hit Command R, or again the play button, and let's tap this. And it says tab button. Let's tap it again. Great. We have tapped that button a couple of times, and it looks really, really nice. So let's jump into today's problem. So let's solve it. We want to show an alert. So let's do that. So I will remove this. So it's a little bit of clutter. And you know, if you work with alerts, you have to write a lot. So you have to initialize it, you have to create actions for it, but not now. We are just going to use the simple UIAlert controller and dot, and we have a few. So a simple one with a style, and that is alert or action sheet, title and message. We have a title message with alert actions, of course, with a completion handler if you wanted to. And we have one that has an array of UI text fields. You could use this for collecting, let's say, usernames and passwords or emails or something like that. So I will go with the, and that is straightforward after, it's simply adding a UI text field as we would add a UI alert action. So I will use this second one. So the alert style, let's go for alert. And the title, let's have this warning, the message. This is our message, okay. And let's add some actions, and these are an array or UI of UI alert actions. So let's do that. Let's create an okay action and a cancel action. It doesn't really matter, you could use anything. I believe that you should have at least 2, but if you only want 1, then you should use the first one that has only a title and a message and it says OK. So yeah, go ahead and check those out, how they look. So let's see, OK action, and that is a UI alert action with a title of, let's say, OK style. Let's use default here, handler, and inside the handler we have an action coming back, but I rarely use that. I would just print something out like log, let's say success. You could basically use this for anything. You could navigate away from the scene or something else. So tabbed, okay. One last thing, I want to create a console button. Okay, let console action. Just make that a capital A there. And that will be of type UI alert action. Title console, of course. The style, and let's talk a bit about style. The console is basically bold. The default is normal, and the descriptive is red. So I will just choose console there, and let's add nil for the handler, because we don't want to do that, have anything to do about that. So let's just copy and paste those 2 actions inside our actions. There we go, the console action 2. And basically I don't want to do anything after we have presented our alert controller. So yeah, let's just build and run and see how that looks. And then I would just move on to showing you some action sheets. Warning, this is our message. We can console out. Let's just console out. Nothing happens. Let me just tab that again. Let's click on OK there. And it says tabbed. OK. Great. Let me just show you the other type of destructive. There we go. This is kind of showing the user that, okay, this is serious. Okay, with red. Okay. And finally, let's choose another style. Let's see here, dot action sheet, not alert. Let's hit Command R And yeah, with just a few lines of code, there you have your alert. You can navigate away. You can do whatever you want once action is selected. So there we go. Warning, this is our message. Okay, cancel. Pretty straightforward. If you would have added, let's add another one. Okay, action, and let's say, not sure, maybe not sure, maybe we're not sure, action. Not sure, and this will be a normal one. I believe that's, no, it's a default, it's called default, and tabbed, not sure. And for the success, I would just use warning. Okay, let's build an, oh, sorry. We need to add that not sure action to the list of our actions there. Great. There we go, not sure action. Let's hit Command R or that play button and hit the tap me. There we go. Okay, not sure. If we tap on not sure. Okay, tap on okay and cancel. Okay, that does nothing. Okay, let me just show you that on the alert, it's in Command R. Yeah, and basically that is it. Let's just test this out. Tap me, okay, not sure, cancel. Really, really awesome and really simple to implement. If you have been ever working with UI alert controllers, you can do know that it's real pain. And as a bonus, this takes care of the iPad crash. You don't need to know about it. If you do know about it, then I'm pretty sorry that you encountered that. It's a real pain to fix, but this works on iPads too. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell, because in the next video we are going to talk about HUDs and you don't want to miss that out. So hit that notification bell to get notified instantly when I put that out. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.